One of my influences on this record was a lute composer named Silvius Weiss, who was around the same time that Bach was. And I took some chords from him. Thank you, Silvius, wherever you are, for lending me your chords. And I played them when I wrote the song. I played them so I could hear both the chord and the bass note, which was usually different. There were slash chords, like I'd play an A chord, but the C sharp would be in the bass. So that's sort of the whole thing would happen through the whole song. He's always putting a different bass note with the chord. The next chord would be an E chord, but B is in the bass. So he's not using the low E, just using the B. So that way your bass line becomes like... So the next one had the bass note was a B flat, and he had that was actually the third of F sharp. If you play F sharp chord, there's your third. Da, 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 one, two, three. So it's a lot of explanation, but basically here are the chords that I got from Silvius Weiss. I thought those were really cool chords, and he played them great, had all sorts of melodies with them. And I decided to do it in a rhythm that went da 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 da. So it sounded like. The only thing that happened is I wanted to make it less cloudy. To me, when I play that whole thing on the guitar, it works pretty well, but. Since I have a bass player in the band, why not have the bass player play those bass notes, and I can go and do a little higher voicing. And this is sort of influenced by listening to a lot of Pete Townsend stuff. Pete Townsend tends to play higher voicings. So instead of playing that whole chord with the bass note, I decided to play a higher... and let the bass player play the C sharp. So I just played, instead of... I played it up higher. And it gave me more clarity to the mix, and I love that sound. So without the bass note, and if you add the bass note in there, it rocks. And the higher voicing would be...